Lake Bunyonyi's scene from one of the hills, which bear one of the good accommodation facilities in Kabale Hills. There is no question that this is sheer beauty, even for those that have difficulty in seeing beauty in nature. While touring the Kigezi tourism sector by the State Minister for Tourism, it was not clear whether what the minister said was rhetoric or business fact.
If Rwanda advertises, Uganda advertises, Kenya advertises, a tourist who can even be in a month can be in East Africa. He spends here 5 days, he's in Rwanda 5 days, he goes to Nairobi, that's the way to go. We are not in competition, we are in partnership.
For now, Rwanda, in as far as Bunyonyi is concerned, is an anchor for tourism.
This is a holding ground for people going to Windi, see the gorilla, see the gorillas. And they stay with us here for 2 days, they go and track and come back. And now we also have a very best link now. KLM brings visitors from Europe and they land in Kigali and they're here within 1 hour. So they no longer go through Kampala, they come direct here.
That tourists to Windi go through Kigali might be partnership or it might actually be competition. This wasn't the fact that visitors to Uganda, on average, spend less of the monies they carry when they tour Uganda. This is why players are calling for government intervention.
The private operators are charging $400 from Kampala, from Entebbe to Chisoro, which is as costly as going to Nairobi or as costly as going to South Africa. So there's a need for a government to think about what they can do to have this happen so that we have our guests who arrive in Entebbe and they can fly direct within 30 minutes, 40, 35 minutes to be here.
Meanwhile, in conservation, which goes along with tourism, traders in illegal ivory and wildlife may be doomed once the Wildlife Act is passed.
We want to strengthen law enforcement. We want to strengthen the powers of the Wildlife Authority in terms of combating illegal wildlife trade. We've always thought that the kind of sentences and the fines that come with trading illegal wildlife are not strong enough. We're going to strengthen that. We're going to strengthen the judicial systems. We are going to strengthen the distribution of the proceeds which come out of conservation.
Meantime, the conflict between wild animals and people has hatched some innovative and natural ways of being resolved through growth of chili by communities in conflict.
Communities are putting, chili buffer gardens that stop such a raid. But also chili is one of the most lucrative cash crop. A kilo of chili goes to 12,000. Compared to a kilo of cotton that is below 3,000.
There seems to be more action than just words for tourism sector these days, and it's arguably one of the more sustainable natural resources besides oil. Samuel Setumba, NTV Business.